I know, I seem to have a bit of an obsession with connecting fans to ESPHome. This is my third video on the subject, but this time it's by special request, and I've put together a little project that lets you control the speed of the fan and also use a temperature sensor to set that speed. I'm going to start by telling you how not to do this, so as you can avoid making the same mistakes that I did when building this project. Now, this is an IRF 520 MOSFET. You connect your input power here and your normal 12 volt 2 pin fan connection here, and then you send a PWM signal to this pin here. In theory, this device will adjust the output voltage based on the PWM signal that you provide, meaning that you could control the speed of any normal fan. However, in the real world, this just doesn't work. The module buzzes really loudly as soon as you try to drop below 100% speed, and it can take ages to decide to ramp the voltage up, like a couple of minutes at times, meaning that changes aren't very immediate, and you never get full voltage across the output terminals either, so most of the time the fan just doesn't spin very fast, even at full speed. So don't bother with this method. Here's what you should do instead. Don't worry, this is not as scary as it looks. It's just laid out bare on this breadboard so as you can easily see what's happening. Let's start with the power supply. I'm running this project using a 12 volt power adapter. I've cut off the barrel connector so as I can screw the cables into these green terminals. Make sure you note which wire is positive and which is negative. Usually the wire with markings on is positive, but make sure you know using a multimeter, or sometimes there's a diagram on the power supply's label. This is a 12 volt fan made by Arctic. I'll put a link in the description, but specifically this is the PWM version, or pulse width modulation. That means it has a 4-pin connector. This is important because that 4th pin allows you to signal to the fan how fast you'd like it to spin. Let's go through the rest of the components I have here then. This big black module here is a voltage converter. It takes the 12 volt input and drops it down to 5 volts. There are lots of different variations of this module out there, but this specific one actually gives me two USB ports, which is very convenient for plugging in the D1 Mini. And then the D1 Mini, of course, is over here, and it's the brains of the operation. It's going to be our link between these various components and Home Assistant. This module here with the blue box on its back is a relay. Now this is needed because a 12 volt PWM fan can't actually be stopped totally just by controlling the PWM signal. Even at the lowest setting, the fan will still be turning, so we use the relay to toggle the power to the fan. And then lastly, there's this little module here, which is a BMP 280 temperature sensor. I know it looks like a lot of tangled wires there, but there is a method to the madness, and I'll show you on the wiring diagram. You can see the 12 volt power supply coming in at the bottom, and it splits off firstly into the voltage converter to power the D1 Mini, and secondly to the relay and fan. The 12 volt positive terminates in the NO, or normally open connector, on the relay, and then continues up to the positive input of the fan, which is pin 2. This allows the relay to physically switch the 12 volt power to the fan, breaking the circuit by default, meaning that the fan is truly off. The relay itself is powered by the 5 volt output from the D1 Mini, but the important connection here is the green wire running to pin D3. This is where the microcontroller will send the signal to the relay to tell it to switch on or off. To control the speed of the fan, we also need to send a PWM signal. This purple wire connects from pin D0 on the microcontroller to pin 4 of the fan. And lastly, then we have the BMP 280 module, which uses the I2C connection on the microcontroller. I'm using the module's default pins of D1 and D2 for SCL and SDA communication, and of course the module itself needs a 3.3 volt power supply. I just want to talk about that voltage converter before I carry on. It's quite a big, bulky component, and this one is designed for use in cars to give you some hardwired USB ports. You could instead go with what's called a buck converter. These are much smaller and cheaper, but quite often you need to manually tune the output voltage using a screwdriver and a multimeter. And then they quite often need a heatsink too to stop them melting. I've chosen this pre-built sealed module instead because it's a lot easier for beginners to use, but if you know what you're doing and want to make this more compact, then you can use a buck converter. Anyway, once you've connected it all together, you'll need to program the D1 Mini. Now, I suggest you remove the D1 Mini from the project board and plug it directly into your PC using the USB port for this part. Then you can connect it back into the rest of the project after you've done the initial flashing. Just in case you've accidentally cross-wired something, you don't want to push 12 volts back down into your computer's USB port. Starting at the top, you can always change the name to whatever you like. Now, the purpose of this configuration is to automatically control the speed of the fan using the temperature reported by the BMP280 sensor. If you're not interested in the fan being automatically controlled and just want to control the speed manually in Home Assistant, then there are a lot of lines you can remove. I will put a second configuration up on my website along with this one, which doesn't include the fancy automations based on temperature, and I'll link to that in the description. So to control the fan speed based on the temperature, you need to provide a few details. Firstly, you need to set the lowest temperature at which the fan will turn on. So below this temperature, the fan will be totally off. Then you set the temperature above which the fan will run at 100%. Finally, you set the minimum fan speed as a percentage. So I've got that set to 25% here. So when the temperature reaches the minimum temperature threshold you've set, which I've got as 20 degrees, the fan will turn on to the minimum speed, which is set here at 25%. It will then speed up in a linear fashion with the temperature until it reaches 100% speed at the maximum temperature value you specified. So in this case, when it reaches 30 degrees, the fan will be at 100%. Scrolling down then to look at the setup, which starts on line 38 here. You can see this is where you define the pins that are used for the temperature sensor. So I'm using pins D2 and D1. And down here on line 45, you define the pin used to control the speed of the fan. The ESP8266 chipset that's used by the D1 Mini doesn't have hardware PWM support. So this is a software emulated PWM. The PWM frequency of a 12 volt case fan tends to be between 20 to 30 kilohertz. And for this particular fan I'm using, 25 kilohertz seems to work perfectly. You also need to define a GPIO switch to control the relay, and I'm using pin D3 for that. I'm going to scroll down a bit now because we're moving into the interesting stuff. The temperature sensor here is what controls the whole internal automation. Take a look at the section here, which executes every time the temperature value changes. On each value change, it calls a script named setFanState. We'll take a look at that script shortly, but first I need to show you the fan entity itself. This is a standard ESPHome fan entity, which references the PWM object that we created earlier. However, there are a couple of actions associated with it. So when the fan entity is switched on or off, it calls a function to toggle the relay too. The end result is that when the fan is turned on, the relay is turned on, and the speed of the fan set by PWM. When you turn off the fan, it turns off the relay, cutting power to it totally. And lastly, I'm going to scroll down to show you the script itself. This script is run every time the temperature changes, so the first thing it does is to see if the temperature is below the minimum threshold you set. If it is, it turns off the fan. You can see that bit here. If it isn't though, then it needs to first turn on the fan, then work out how fast the fan should be spinning. This is just a linear calculation that assumes that the fan should be turning at full speed by the time it reaches the maximum threshold you set. So as the temperature increases, the speed of the fan will increase too. And this is what you'll see if you add this to your dashboard. There's a temperature sensor here and a fan entity here. And you can turn it on if you want and adjust its speed quite easily. But because I have the temperature sensor automation version of the configuration installed, the fan will keep adjusting its speed on its own or turn off whenever it thinks it needs to. But if this was the manual control version of the config, then you could play away and make any changes here you want. I haven't packaged this one up into a nice case or anything this time because I built this version purely for this video to demonstrate a concept. I'm personally quite happy using just a standard on-off fan, which has fewer components and is less likely to go wrong. They also take up a lot less space. Anyway, I'll put all of the details and configuration up on my website, and a link to that will be in the description. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, then please give it a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.